Hey guys, Trevor Boone from Emerald City Guitars, and my pick of the day is this 1972 Gibson Les Paul Custom. One of my first guitars and my first real nice guitar was a Gibson Les Paul Custom, black like this. It was like an 88, broken headstock that was repaired. And so it became one of my favorite guitars. It was really dear to me being my first real nice instrument. And I just thought it always looked amazing, the gold hardware, the ebony board. It was just a cool guitar to play and I felt like it looked great. So the Gibson Les Paul came out in 52, and in 1953, Les Paul himself had gone to Gibson and said, I want to, you know, something that's a little bit fancier with the split diamond inlays. That's pretty much, it's a Super 400 headstock essentially, top their line at the point at that time. So a little bit more luxurious guitar. He said he wanted something that looked like a tuxedo when he played. And they came out with the Les Paul Custom. So it's an early guitar that's been played by so many different players through different eras, different genres, the jazz guys, to the Randy Rhodes metal guys. And it's just a really, really cool alternative to your regular Gibson Les Paul standard. So this is in 1972. So by this point, they introduced the maple cap. All the early ones were full mahogany, mahogany body, neck. This is before they did the 3-ply maple neck, so it's still that really nice mahogany neck, ebony board, mother of pearl inlay, the gold hardware, and something unique, it has the Gibson branded humbuckers, which you only really see, I think, on 72, 73. It did have an extra strap button drilled in right here that someone took out. We didn't touch it up or anything, didn't really feel like it was necessary, but the guitar is original. It's got a little bit of weight to her, but it sounds so good. It comes with the original hard shell case and just a cool classic guitar that's, you know, it's not cheap by any means, but it's under $10,000, you know, and it's a cool piece of Gibson history from a cool era. So anyways, today I'm gonna plug this through a Goodsell Custom 33. This one came in used and I love this amp. It's a 210 model, 33 or 17 watts, kind of like an AC30. I've always adored these amps, so we're gonna match these up and see how they sound. All right, there you have it, a 1972 Gibson Les Paul Custom, and I played that through this Goodsell Custom 33. Both of these are available on our website, and yeah, thanks for watching. See you next time.